Oke, silakan kembali ke kursi masing-masing. Kita akan segera memulai. Please return to your seats. We are going to start soon. Marilah kita membuka kitab Bilangan pasal 27. Please turn your Bible to the book of Numbers chapter 27. Kitab Bilangan pasal 27. The book of Numbers chapter 27. Kita membaca ayat 15 hingga 23. Let's read this together, verse 15 to verse 23. 1, 2, 3. Lalu berkatalah Musa kepada Tuhan, biarlah Tuhan Allah dari roh segala makhluk mengangkat atas umat ini seorang yang mengepalai mereka waktu keluar dan masuk, dan membawa mereka keluar dan masuk, supaya umat Tuhan jangan hendaknya seperti domba-domba yang tidak mempunyai gembala. Lalu Tuhan berfirman kepada Musa, ambillah Yosua bin Nun, seorang yang penuh roh, letakkanlah tanganmu atasnya, suruhlah ia berdiri di depan Imam Eliazar dan di depan segenap umat. Lalu berikanlah kepadanya perintahmu di depan mata mereka itu, dan berilah dia sebagian dari kewibawaanmu, supaya segenap umat Israel mendengarkan dia. Dia harus berdiri di depan Imam Eliazar, supaya Eliazar menanyakan keputusan Urim bagi dia di hadapan Tuhan. Atas titahnya mereka akan keluar, dan atas titahnya mereka akan masuk, ia beserta semua orang Israel, segenap umat itu. Maka Musa melakukan seperti yang diperintahkan Tuhan kepadanya. Ia memanggil Yosua dan menyuruh dia berdiri di depan Imam Eliazar dan di depan segenap umat itu. Lalu ia meletakkan tangannya atas Yosua dan memberikan kepadanya perintahnya, seperti yang difirmankan Tuhan dengan perantaraan Musa. Mari kita berdoa, let us pray. kami sudah membaca firman-Mu ya Tuhan. Sekarang kami mohon berbicaralah supaya kami mengerti firman-Mu. We have read your word, so now we pray, Father, please explain this to us so we will understand it. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus kami berdoa. In the name of Jesus we all pray. Amen. Halaman 73, page 73. In the hands out that you have in your hands. Cara Tuhan adalah terbaik. God's way is the best. Alkitab adalah catatan tentang perkataan dan perbuatan Tuhan, menyelamatkan manusia dari hukuman dosa. We all know that the Bible contains the word and the act of the Lord God saving mankind from the penalty of sin. Namun di dalamnya kita pun dapat membaca tentang cara Tuhan melakukan pekerjaannya. But in it, we can also read about the different ways of God's doing His work. Dari pembacaan firman Tuhan hari ini, dapat kita belajar tentang cara Tuhan melanjutkan pekerjaannya dari Musa kepada Yosua. Tambahkan kata Yosua. From the reading of the scripture today, we can learn about God's way of continuing His work from Moses to Joshua. Jadi ada beberapa yang kita bisa pelajari hari ini. So there are several lessons that we can glean today. Pertama, yang dapat kita pelajari adalah bahwa pergantian kepemimpinan tidak berarti pergantian program kerja. Tambahkan kata program. First thing we can learn is that the change of leadership does not mean the change of work program. Pergantian kepemimpinan adalah pergantian orang, tambahkan kata orang, yang melaksanakan program kerja. So you see, the change of leadership is the change of the personnel, the people who carry out the program. Dan sebagaimana kita tahu, program kerja ditentukan oleh Tuhan Allah. And as we all know, the works program is actually made and determined by God. Jadi, tugas pemimpin yang baru bukanlah merancang program kerja yang baru. Tugasnya adalah meneruskan, tambahkan kata meneruskan. Program kerja yang telah dilaksanakan selama ini. So, the task of the new leader is not to actually make a new program. His job is actually to continue the work program that has been done. Di dalam perjalanannya, sudah tentu program kerja dapat berubah. Namun, perubahan bukan berasal dari si pemimpin, melainkan dari Tuhan, yang biasanya menghadirkan perubahan lewat kondisi atau kebutuhan. Tambahkan kata kebutuhan yang muncul. In this process, of course, works program can change. But the change does not stem from the leader, but from God, who usually brings about the change by means of condition or needs that arises. Stop dulu. Jadi saudara, Tuhan akan selalu mengganti orang. We need to know that God will always replace the personnel, the people who do the work. Tapi program kerja tidak berubah, semua dari Tuhan. But the program, the works program itself doesn't change. It comes from God. Dalam prosesnya atau dalam pelaksanaannya, program kerja bisa dimodifikasi. sesuai dengan kondisi dan kebutuhan. But of course, yeah, in its execution, the works program will be modified by God, yeah, in accordance to the need or the condition. Jadi sekali lagi, saudara, tugasnya si pemimpin yang menggantikan bukanlah membuat sebuah program kerja yang baru. So once again, the task of the new leader is not to come up with a new program, work program, no. Just carry out what has been done. In this process, in this execution, if God wants to modify, so be it. Tambahan. Teruskan lagi. Selama 40 tahun, Musa memimpin Israel. Dan pada masa itu, ia mesti memimpin bukan saja dalam peperangan melawan bangsa-bangsa yang berusaha merintangi Israel masuk ke tanah Kanaan, tetapi juga memimpin mereka dalam pergumulan hidup. Tambahkan kata hidup. Di padang gurun, seperti sakit penyakit, tidak ada daging untuk dimakan dan air untuk diminum. So for 40 years, Moses led the people of Israel. But at the time when he led the people of Israel, he did not only lead them to fight against nations that tried to block Israel from entering the promised land, but he also led them through life struggles in the desert. For example, like diseases, illnesses, no meat to eat, or no water to drink. Ya, inilah yang dikerjakan oleh Musa sebagai pemimpin. So this was what Moses did as a leader. Nah, sekarang kita lihat Yosua. Yosua juga mesti memimpin Israel berperang. Tambahkan kata berperang. Menaklukkan dan menghalau penduduk Kanaan. Joshua also led Israel through the wars, the battles, because he had to overcome or conquer the natives of the Canaanite, of the Canaan. Namun selain dari itu, Yosua mesti membagi, tambahkan kata membagi, tanah Kanaan dan menyerahkannya kepada setiap suku Israel. On top of it, Joshua had to divide the land and gave each portion to each tribe of Israel. Jadi, kita bisa lihat ya, program kerja berubah sesuai dengan kondisi dan kebutuhan. So you see, the works program changes in accordance to the condition and the need. Saudara, kadang-kadang kita ini nih ya, karena baru saja diangkat menjadi pemimpin, kita ingin mempunyai legasi atau meninggalkan warisan supaya orang mengingat kita. There's always this temptation for a new leader to leave behind a legacy. Something that people can say, oh, you did it. Saudara, ini godaan yang mesti dilawan oleh semua yang mau menjadi pemimpin. This is a temptation that we all must resist, especially if we want to become a leader. Ya, jauh lebih baik kita teruskan saja yang sudah digariskan. It is best just to carry on what has been actually proposed or planned. Dalam perjalanannya, kalau mesti diubah, Tuhan nanti akan munculkan kebutuhan itu. If something has to be modified or adjusted, God will show it to us in the future. Jadi kita gak usah ya memunculkan sesuatu yang baru supaya nanti orang melihat, oh, kita meninggalkan sebuah peninggalan yang berharga. So don't look for or don't seek legacy now. Don't think about, okay, let me do something different, something new, so people will always remember me by. We don't have to do that. Sambung lagi. Kedua yang dapat kita pelajari adalah, pada dasarnya tugas pemimpin adalah menggembalakan. Tambahkan kata menggembalakan. The second lesson we can glean is that the task of a leader or the primary task of a leader is to shepherd the people. Sebagai gembala, ia berjalan di depan. Ia mengarahkan, menuntun, dan memperhatikan kawanan dombanya. So as a shepherd, he walks in front of the flocks. He gives direction, he guides them, and he cares for his flock. Oleh karena Musa menggembalakan pada masa perang, berjalan di depan berarti memasang badan, menjadi perisai, sekaligus menjadi target serangan musuh. When Moses led, he led during the war. It means walking in front of his flock means he has to actually be the shield. He has to give his body and he becomes a target of attack. Karena dia yang mesti berjalan di depan. Dengan kata lain, gembala mesti bersedia berkorban nyawa, tambahkan kata berkorban, demi keselamatan kawanan dombanya. Simply put, a shepherd must be willing to sacrifice his life for his flock. Bukan saja Musa menyusun strategi peperangan, ia pun turut berperang. So you see, not only that Moses plan on the battle, what to do during the battle, he himself fought. He himself had to go down to the field, the battlefield. Itu sebab orang yang menggantikan Musa haruslah seseorang yang bukan saja dapat menggembalakan, tapi juga memimpin Israel berperang. And that's the reason. Whoever succeeded Moses had to be somebody who not only could shepherd the flock, but also lead Israel to war. Yosua dipilih bukan karena ia dekat dengan Musa, melainkan karena ia memenuhi syarat, tambahkan kata syarat. So you see, Joshua was chosen not because he was close to Moses, but because he qualified for the job. Ia dapat menggembalakan dan memimpin Israel berperang. He could shepherd the flock and he could lead Israel to war. Saudara, seorang pemimpin dipilih jadinya bukan karena kedekatan dengan orang di dalam kepengurusan itu. So you see, a leader is chosen not because he is close to somebody in the group. Bukan. Seorang pemimpin dipilih karena dia memang punya kemampuan untuk melakukan tugasnya. A leader has to be chosen based on qualification, that he can do the job. Nah, saat itu Yosua yang menggantikan Musa harus bisa dua-duanya. Memperhatikan domba-domba, tapi juga memimpin domba-domba ke dalam pertempuran, peperangan. So at the time, whoever succeeded Moses must be qualified to do two things: to shepherd the flock, to care for the people, and to lead the people to war. Jadi kita tahu ya, mesti memenuhi syarat. So we ought to be qualified to become a leader. Ketiga, yang dapat kita pelajari adalah pemimpin umat Tuhan haruslah seorang yang rohani. Tambahkan kata rohani. Third lesson we can glean is that a leader of God's people ought to be a spiritual person. Yosua dipilih karena ia penuh dengan roh, kata firman. You see, Joshua was chosen because he was full of the Spirit. The Spirit of God was on him. Dengan kata lain, kesanggupan bukanlah satu-satunya kriteria. Kesanggupan mesti didasari atas kerohanian. Tambahkan kata kerohanian. So you see, ability is not the only criterion. Ability had to be supported by or founded on spirituality. Musa berjalan erat dengan Tuhan, bukan saja ia berbicara kepada Tuhan, Tuhan pun berbicara kepada Musa. Moses walked closely with the Lord. Not only did he talk to God, speak to God, God also spoke to him. Hal yang sama dapat kita lihat pada Yosua. Bukan saja ia berbicara kepada Tuhan, Tuhan pun berbicara kepadanya. The same thing we can see in Joshua. Not only did he speak to God, God also spoke to him. Inilah tanda kerohanian. This is the sign of being spiritual. Jadi bukan pengetahuan, melainkan ketaatan dan keakraban. Tambahkan kata keakraban. The sign of spirituality is, or being spiritual is, not knowledge, how much we know, but it is obedience and intimacy. Obedient to God, intimate with God. Saudara, Musa berbicara kepada Tuhan berkali-kali. Tapi kita bisa baca, Tuhan berbicara kepada Musa berkali-kali loh. We can read in the Bible, Moses spoke to God frequently. But almost the same amount of times, God spoke to him. Itu tuh pertanda adanya sebuah relasi yang akrab. That's a sign there is that intimate relationship between Moses and God. Dan kita lihat hal yang sama juga di Yosua. Same thing we can see in Joshua. Dia berbicara kepada Tuhan. Tapi kita juga baca Tuhan berbicara kepada dia. We can read Joshua speak to God. But we can also read God speaks to him. Saudara, kita mesti sering berbicara kepada Tuhan. We must speak to God often. Tapi ini yang membuat Tuhan berbicara kepada kita. Kita menaatinya. But what makes God speak to us is our obedience. Jadi kalau kita hanya berbicara kepada Tuhan, tapi tidak menaatinya, dia tidak akan berbicara kepada kita. So you see, if we only speak to God, but we do not obey him, he will not speak to us. He will only speak to us if we listen to him, we obey him. Nah, jadi inilah tanda sebuah relasi dengan Tuhan yang akrab. Once again, this is the sign of being spiritual. Terakhir, yang keempat yang dapat kita pelajari adalah pergantian kepemimpinan seyogianya berjalan secara bertahap. Tambahkan kata bertahap. The fourth and last lesson we can learn is that change of leadership ought to be done gradually or naturally. Tuhan menyuruh Musa untuk memberikan Yosua sebagian dari wewenangmu, kata firman Tuhan. You see, God commanded Moses to give Joshua some of his authority. Not all, some of his authority. Setelah pelantikan, Musa tetap melayani, bahkan ia masih memimpin Israel berperang melawan bangsa Midian. As you can read later, you can see that after Moses anointed Joshua to take his place, Moses continued to lead Israel. In fact, he led Israel through another battle against the Midianites. Jadi inilah prosesnya, saudara-saudara. So we can see this process. Berawal dari Yosua mendampingi Musa. beralih menjadi Musa mendampingi Yosua, berakhir dengan Musa melepaskan Yosua. So you see this progression. It begins with Joshua walks with Moses, assist Moses. It turns into Moses walks with Joshua, Moses assist Joshua, and it ends with Moses releasing Joshua. Sebaiknya begitu, saudara, cara pergantiannya. Peralihan berjalan mulus bila dilakukan secara bertahap, terutama bila mata tertuju pada melanjutkan pekerjaan Tuhan. Tambahkan kata melanjutkan. So you see, the change of leadership can go on smoothly if it is done gradually, naturally, especially if all eyes are fixed on carrying on the work of the Lord. That's it. Kita nggak pikir apa yang kita mau kerjakan, kita hanya pikir pekerjaan Tuhan dilanjutkan. So we don't focus on what we want to do, but just continuing what has been done, what God has been doing. Itu saja. Ada pertanyaan atau komentar? Silakan. Can you speak louder, please? I have a problem now. Thank you.
How do you discern God's voice?
How do we discern God's voice? Okay. How do we know that the voice speaks to us is actually God's voice? Something like that, yeah? Okay. Guideline, number one. Whatever it is he tells us to do or he says to us cannot contradict to what is written in the Bible. Yeah, whatever it is he says to us cannot contradict what is written in the Bible. Jadi misalnya, Bepi, bunuhlah Paul Gunadi. It's a far off example. Of course, it is not of God, because it is in contradiction to the word of God in the Bible. Okay? Jadi apapun yang diminta atau dikatakan, mesti konsisten, tidak berlawanan dengan firman Tuhan. Secondly, how do we know it is God's word? In my experience here, when the voice tells me to do something, then I know is good. So good that I don't want to do it. Most likely I know it is from him. When I have to do something that is like my nature, easy to do, okay, that's maybe God's will, but most likely it is also my will. But when the voice tells me to do something that I don't want to do, because it is too good and it is too hard, most likely it is from him.
Example.
Okay, saya berikan contoh ya. I'll give you an example. Maybe I shared this with you a long time ago. When I was working before as a social worker, satu hari I saw my colleague walk in to the office limping. So I asked him, his name is Gordon. Gordon, what happened to you? Oh, I don't know what happened. My leg is hurting me, so when I walk, it's really painful. Oh, okay. No big deal. I happened to talk to Gordon before that about spiritual matters. He seems to be like far from God now. So after I asked him, and then he told me, there's something wrong with this leg. I continue working, but suddenly there was that voice speaking to me. Pray for him, and he will see the glory of God. Oh no, I can pray in the church, not at work, especially in the county of Los Angeles. I did not want to. We were all working in the office. I didn't feel comfortable praying. But it is actually a good command. a holy command. Too holy for me. I didn't want to do it. So I continued working, didn't want to do it, but the voice kept telling me, pray for him and he will see the glory of God. Because I could not make that voice stop speaking to me. And I know it was from him. I knew. Yeah, so I knew I had to do it. So finally, I chose to do it. So I said this, Lord, I will do it on condition. I will only do it in the restroom. When he goes to the restroom, or when I go to the restroom, and if I see him in the restroom with me, I will pray for him. Let me ask you, what are the chances of me and he having the same need to go to the restroom at the same time? You got it. Very slim. Very slim. So I didn't think about it anymore. I just said, Lord, if it is your will, I will only pray for him in the restroom. But it has to happen that when I'm in the restroom, he has to be in the same restroom. I don't know how long after that I have the need for the restroom, so I went to the restroom. After I finished, I was washing my hands. I was so happy because he wasn't there. But right after I finished washing my hands, the door slung open, he walked in. When he walked in, I had only two choices. I knew. I obey God or I disobey God. That's all. So obvious, so clear. So I decided to obey God. So I talked to him again about his leg. He said, I don't know why. It's so painful now. Oh, okay. We're just talking. Because I was still struggling. But finally I said this, Gordon, can I pray for you? Oh, sure. You can pray for me. Most likely he thought about I will pray for him at home. But I said, can I pray for you now? So he said, oh, sure. So I just knelt before him. And then I put my hands on his knee. I prayed for him. While I was praying for his knee, I was praying, Lord, please do not have anybody walk in here, please. Because for goodness sake, I'm a man, he's a man. In America, you don't do that. In Indonesia, it's okay, but not here. So I pray for him after that. Okay, Gordon, goodbye. A few days later, when I was working, suddenly he walked in. And he said to me this, hey Paul, remember the other day? Remember I was hurting, my leg was hurting? I said, yeah. Well, I don't know what happened. It was God or whatever. But I just want to let you know, I'm healed. I have no more pain. When he's finished saying that, that voice came back to me. He saw the glory of God. So, it happens. Not every day, no. And I'm glad it's not every day. Because to be honest, sometimes it is just too hard to do it.
So what's the hard things to do?
I'm sorry?
The hard, you see two points, right? One is good, that's definitely...
Too holy. Holy and good.
Holy.
When it is like too sacred, too holy for us to do, most likely it is of him.
So it's also too difficult.
Yes.
So too holy and too difficult, really interchange.
Usually it is from him. Usually. 9 out of 10. Okay.
Thank you.